7 weeks of radiation and 3 months of chemotherapy. That intense treatment plan has been the standard of care in head and neck cancer for years. But now research at Dana-Farber Cancer Institute is looking into different treatment options based on the understanding that not all head and neck cancers are the same.
When we all use the word head and neck cancer, we're lumping everyone together. But these are very different cancers.
Dr. Robert Haddad says the research is looking into whether less toxic treatment options are just as effective in head and neck cancer that's related to the infection with the human papillomavirus known as HPV.
We're seeing a shift in the epidemiology where the majority of patients we see today in our clinics are younger and they have HPV, head and neck cancer. They're non-smokers, they rarely use alcohol, usually professionals with younger kids at home.
And Dr. Haddad says these HPV-related head and neck cancer patients have a much better prognosis.
In fact, the cure rate for these patients is around 90%, even with locally advanced disease.
A research trial at Dana-Farber is looking into de-intensifying the treatment for these patients. If the cancer is HPV-related, the patients undergo robotic surgery, and then, depending on the pathology, they will either receive no further treatment but be closely monitored or receive a lower dose radiation treatment. The goal is to maintain or even improve the high cure rate while improving quality of life.
There'll be less dry mouth, less dental problems, less scar tissue, less fibrosis, less use of a feeding tube for these patients. So significant improvement in quality of life.
Dr. Haddad says this is a long-term project following patients for a period of time to make sure the cancer does not return and the quality of life parameters are met. For Dana-Farber News, I'm Victoria Warren.